We're talking with Mississippi College head coach John Bland as we get set for this weekend's season finale against the Delta State University Statesmen. First of all, coach, let's go back and look at that West Alabama game. Choctaws came up short in that contest. You know, to open the ball game, the Choctaws went backwards on that opening drive, but really bounced back into the first half. Was able to move the ball very, very effectively in that first half against the Tigers.
Sure did. You know what? They're really good on defense. They have a lot of speed and size, and it wasn't an adjustment, but we did have a new lineman in place of Blaine Cannon, and Tyler did a great job. He did a real good job to start the game off, though. He missed his assignment, and it caused one negative play, and then one of those, and then we had another one where we missed a block. And you know what? Give them credit. They played very hard. But it just took us a little bit of adjustment to the speed, and that was just those three plays. And after that, we had a long drive right down there to score, to tie it 7-7. And then we got a stop, and then we come back again and get another drive and go up 14-7, if I remember right. And then it was a good ball game from then on out. We just couldn't quite get enough going in the second half to finish them off.
And I thought their passing game was perhaps the most potent that the Choctaws have seen this year. You know, McDaniels and his very talented receiving core was able to really hook up there in the second half, especially. They had some receivers that were among the best we've seen this year.
They were a big target at tight end also, and a lot of good receivers that could get open, and they caught the ball well. So it was a challenge for us. Hopefully we'll be up to that challenge this week against Delta State, but it was a definite challenge for us, and we couldn't keep the ball long enough to keep our defense off the field. So it was a combination of both offense and defense.
Well, you know, Aaron Fiesel got hurt in that ball game.
He
ran three plays himself and got hurt on that third play. Talk just a little bit about his injury and what you can tell us about that and how he's doing.
Well, he's doing good. You know what? He's a good kid, good young man, and just hate it for any player when you get hurt like that. It was a traumatic injury. But he's going to be fine. They have everything that the doctors are saying. They're going to be able to fix it, and he'll be just fine. But you know, Aaron, also on a positive note, he won an award. He's been recognized for an award, and that's the AFCA, stands for the American Football Coaches Association, All-State Good Works Team. And I know we've already mentioned this, and it's been on Twitter and all that kind of thing. But they came out to practice last night. Aaron made it to practice. His leg has been really swelled up, really big. You know, with an injury like that, it's going to be. But it was extremely tough for him to get around. But he made it out to practice and got honored with that at practice in front of his teammates, which is unbelievable. It's 22 people in the country at all levels that are on this team. That's Division 1A, has 11 spots, okay? The rest of them, that's 1AA, Division 2, Division 3, and NAI, which consists of I don't know how many football teams and how many players, but 11 are chosen from that. He won that award. He's on that. He's going to the Sugar Bowl, and we'll be wearing our Choctaw jersey. We're proud of him. And just happy for him there, very disappointed that this happened to him, and we're so sorry for that. And that's part of sports, and hate that it happened to us, though, and hate that it happened to Aaron.
Well, you know, in terms of injuries, this year has been, I don't say injury-free, there have been some key injuries,
but not as
in the past. I think a lot of that goes to the strength and conditioning that this team has done in the offseason and through the season as well. I know that program has really developed into a strength of the MC Athletics program.
It has. Coach Shoemaker does a great job, and his staff do a great job. We know that. I will say this. We still have had some injuries, and there's been major injuries, season-ending injuries, and we've seen a lot of that. The thing that is maybe different that keeps us competitive each week is our depth, and that has to do with recruiting and just getting more closer and closer to what we were striving for all along in this Division II transition. So that's been really good, the good part of our team, and the guys have stepped up and done a really good job, just like Tyler Walker stepped up last week. And we have other guys that have stepped up at different positions for losses this season. So we're very fortunate to have a lot of players that can play. But it's also rough when you lose your best, your starters, and guys who mean an awful lot to your plan and that you work on all week long, and that's difficult to overcome. So our coaches and our players have done a good job of keeping us competitive, giving us a chance to compete to win on each Saturday.
Yeah, one of those units where you have a lot of depth is it running back, and this week you're going to have kind of strength versus strength. The Choctaws running game, which is one of the best in the Gulf South Conference. The Delta State run defense, which is one of the best in the Gulf South Conference. So that should be a really good matchup this week.
It is, and as we every week we try to put together a good plan. Comparing us to other running games is probably different. And so hopefully, I know they've had an extra week, not this week, but I think in their off week, they had opportunities to work on things versus shorter, which what they were preparing for, but also against the option. Most teams do take a chance to work on some things that are different or unique for their defense. So they get a chance to work on us for a couple of weeks, which is not good, but it also is something that the option presents a problem for most teams. So hopefully we can, you know, play well, protect the football, and come up with a good plan, which we do have, and execute that plan on Saturday.
Now, the Choctaws have a chance to finish with a 500 record with a win against Delta State. Delta State has a chance to maybe go to the playoffs if they got a win. So there's a lot on the line for both teams here this weekend. A
lot on the line. You know, we looked at it. I think we're undefeated at home right now, which we'd like to keep it that way. If we do, I think it might be the first time since 1988 that the Choctaws have gone undefeated at home and really protecting this house. That's what our players say, and that's what I would like to say too. But it is really big for us, and I think that's a strength. And that's a strength for not only us, but our fans, the ones who have come out there and supported. That means something to them too, because they've been a part of that, protecting our house and really cheering our guys on and making it a home field advantage, which is really good. So hopefully we can continue that right there and win at home, and I know, and get that heritage bell and bring that back to Clinton. That's our goal, and that's what we're going to try to do.
Well, it will be senior day. There's a long list of seniors, too many to really talk about individually in this time that we have, but these are the guys who have helped this program take the next step in the return to Division II. I know it's a special group of players this year for the Choctaws who are seniors.
No doubt. 24 guys, and that's a big group. We've had some groups above 20 before, but this is 24 that have, like you said, they've paved the way, they have laid the foundation, those type of things, all the cliches that you talk about when you're talking about building a program, going from Division III with no scholarships to scholarships, and we didn't just put them all on scholarship that first year. Gradually, and got more and more players on scholarship, more and more guys that could compete at this level. And right now we're seeing that. These seniors have really done that. They decided to make the sacrifice. They decided, I'm going to Mississippi College to pave the way and lay that foundation, and they've done that. We're very proud of them. And you know what, I hope our players that are not seniors see that and they play their best. I know our seniors will play their best this Saturday. I hope the rest of them play their best for those seniors.
Well, Coach, we're looking forward to a good game. And, again, thank you for your time throughout the course of the season.
You bet.
And good luck against Delta State.
Thank you, Reed.